Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and we're back with some exciting news for you. Let's begin with the news which is making headlines in space arena as Blue Origin officially protested against NASA regarding SpaceX's HLS award. On the 26th of April, Jeff Bezos's Blue Origin filed a protest over NASA's decision with the Government Accountability Office. NASA has recently decided to select only SpaceX for their Human Landing System program. This decision was not up to Blue Origin's liking, and they protested. Their protest filing says, NASA has executed a flawed acquisition for the Human Landing System program and moved the goalposts at the last minute. In NASA's own words, it has made a high-risk selection. In a lengthy filing, Blue Origin stated that NASA had not given them and other companies any opportunity to change their proposals to adjust with the agency's reduced budget for the HLS program. They also stated in the filing that NASA had inadequately assessed aspects of their proposal and SpaceX's proposal. Blue Origin also put blame on NASA's assessment of their proposal on different grounds. Blue Origin's protest stated that NASA's source selection rationale improperly justifies the selection of a lone provider as a result of anticipated future funding for the HLS program. The protest also stated that the total amount of Blue Origin's bid and SpaceX's bid combined is $9 billion, which amount is equivalent to NASA's expenses on crew program. NASA had made two awards with less available funding and less out-year funding certainty, according to the filing. Blue Origin also said their national team, which includes Blue Origin, Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Draper, placed a bid of $5.99 billion for the lander program, which was more than twice of SpaceX's bid. Bezos's company squabbles that they're not given the opportunity to reconsider that bid. NASA had requested the U.S. government for about $3.3 billion budget for their HLS program, but they only got $850 million. Due to this lower funding availability, NASA had said that they would not select two bidders as stated earlier. Blue Origin also stated they were plainly prejudiced by the agency's failure to communicate this change in requirements. They even say if they got the opportunity, they could have and would have taken several actions to revise its proposed approach, reduce its price to more closely align with funding available to the agency, and/or propose schedule alternatives. Brent Sherwood, Blue Origin's Senior Vice President of Advanced Development Programs, said that they received no reply for their proposal and only got to know they've not been selected for the award. He also said, if NASA had notified Blue Origin that the source selection official's assessment of available out-year budget would preclude an award absent a repriced Blue Origin proposal, Blue Origin would have welcomed the opportunity to offer specific adjustments in a revised proposal. According to Blue Origin, this single award endangers domestic supply chains for space and negatively impacts jobs across the country. Indicating SpaceX's receiving of the award, Blue Origin said at last, their decision eliminates opportunities for competition, significantly narrows the supply base, and not only delays but also endangers America's return to the moon. Because of that, we filed a protest with the GAO. SpaceX did not release any statements, but Elon Musk did poke fun at the fact Blue Origin has not yet achieved orbit with any of its rockets. "Can't get it up to orbit, LOL," he tweeted, almost taunting Jeff Bezos. Let's move to our next segment based on Starship SN15's static fire. SpaceX's latest Starship prototype, serial number 15 or SN15, test-fired its Raptor engines ahead of high-altitude launch. The vehicle successfully completed its first static fire test. SpaceX was trying to conduct the Starship static fire test from last week. It was on Monday, April 26, at about 5:57 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, when Starship SN15's three Raptor engines ignited while the vehicle remained on the ground. The static fire came 3 days after SpaceX's history-making Crew 2 launch. The test took place at SpaceX's South Texas site near the Gulf Coast hamlet of Boca Chica Village. Starship SN15 static fire completed, preparing for flight later this week, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk stated on Twitter. On April 27th, SpaceX completed another static fire test for additional checking. However, the second test did not stay as long as Monday's static fire. In the second test, SN15 ignited either one or two Raptor engines for a very short duration, 2 to 3 seconds. There could be a chance that SpaceX will replace one or two Raptor engines of SN15 before its launch. Static fire test is a necessary milestone for every spacecraft before moving its launch. This test assures that the vehicle is ready for the launch. Before static fire, SpaceX clears the surrounding area of Boca Chica for safety purposes. SpaceX's previous four starships, SN8, SN9, SN10, and SN11, flew high during their flight test but failed to stick the landing. SN10 went close to conducting a perfect landing but could not make it happen. Musk previously said the Starship SN15 is outfitted with hundreds of improvements, so there's a high chance that SN15 could stick the landing. Like previous Starships, SN15 is targeting a similar 10 to 12 kilometer apogee for its test flight. Soon we could see SpaceX's 165-foot-tall, 50 meters, Starship launched in the Texas sky. SpaceX is working in parallel on the next Starship, SN16. Recently, Mary, aka Boca Chica Gale, tweeted a photo of SN16's nose cone with a beautiful sunrise in the background. It was another beautiful sunrise at SpaceX Boca Chica. Two more sections for the integration tower have arrived. Starship SN16 nose cone sections have been stacked. "It's just another busy day at SpaceX," Mary stated. According to Musk, SpaceX will develop a fully operational Starship and Super Heavy by 2023. This is all regarding SpaceX. Let's move to our next update from China. Recently, the Chinese state rocket company presented a rendering of a spacecraft that's similar to SpaceX's Starship. Could it be that the Chinese rocket company is also developing their own Starship? Let's take a deep look into this topic. Not long ago, China celebrated its 6th National Space Day in Nanjing, China, where they displayed the lunar sample from the Chang'e 5 mission. In that event, China revealed the name of its first Mars rover, Zhurong. The launch is scheduled for May 2021. Apart from that, another thing that China highlighted that day was the suborbital point-to-point transportation. The Chinese Space Agency is planning to develop a vehicle that has a suborbital transportation capability. This vehicle will travel from one point to another point of Earth via suborbital space in less than an hour. Regarding that, China's state rocket manufacturer, the China Academy of Launch Vehicle Technology, presented a video which showed the concepts for potential suborbital passenger flights in the future. The first concept from that video resembled SpaceX's Starship. It showed a large vertical takeoff and vertical landing vehicle with an appearance similar to a Starship. The vehicle shown in the video is made from stainless steel and has a shiny exterior. SpaceX's Starship body is also made from stainless steel rings stacked together. Both vehicles have seamless first and second stages. However, in this case, SpaceX is pretty much ahead of China. 4 years ago, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk revealed the Starship's capability to provide point-to-point in-Earth transportation. According to SpaceX, Starship would take just 39 minutes to cover a distance from New York City to Shanghai in a suborbital flight. SpaceX called its Starship's capability of anywhere on Earth in less than an hour. SpaceX's Starship would also take humans to Mars. China introduced the second concept of suborbital flight with a horizontal takeoff, horizontal landing vehicle. This concept vehicle will use electromagnetic technology in order to launch and land itself horizontally. China plans to develop the suborbital point-to-point transportation by 2045. However, it's unsure whether China will build a Starship-like vehicle or something new. Let's move to today's last news regarding Delta IV heavy rocket launches, NROL-82. On the 26th of April 2021, Monday, United Launch Alliance launched a spy satellite of the National Reconnaissance Office, NRO, into space, aboard their most powerful rocket, the Delta IV Heavy. ULA marks the first launch of the year, 2021, with the NROL-82 mission. At 4:47 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, The Delta IV Heavy lifted off from Space Launch Complex 6, SLC-6, at Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. It carried the NROL-82 satellite into orbit for the NRO. Out of the four remaining Delta IV Heavy rockets in ULA's fleet, one is already launched on Monday with an NRO satellite. The remaining three rockets will also launch missions for the NRO. According to Caroline Kirk, launch commentator in ULA's webcast, Rob Kesselman, Delta IV engineer, had confirmed the successful completion of the early phase of today's flight, and all systems continue to operate nominally. The mobile service tower, a 330-foot tall cover encasing the rocket, used for vehicle assembly and service, was rolled away before the starting of launch countdown. The NROL-82 mission marked the 13th flight of a Delta IV Heavy rocket. The Delta IV Heavy is presently the most powerful rocket in ULA's launch fleet. It uses 465,000 gallons of subcooled liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen as rocket fuel and produces more than 2 million pounds of thrust. ULA plans to launch 10 missions before the end of the year, 2021. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.